class. Today we will understand a brief introduction of the syllabus of the subject Management of Industrial Relations. Now, this is one of your specialization subjects. Now, the subject is Management of Industrial Relations. Now, we will understand why. First of all, why is it there in your curriculum, in your syllabus? What is the need to study industrial relations? First of all, what is the need to manage and industrial relations? As you know, what are relations? You should understand first of all what is the concept of industrial relations. Now, the term industrial relations denotes employment relationship. Now, what is employment relationship? If you join any organization, any place of employment, you are there as a worker or as an employee. Now, on the other end, there is the person who has given you the employment. So, we could understand that on one end, there is the worker or the employee who is being employed, and on the other end, there is the person or group of persons who has provided employment to them. So, we could understand that there is some kind of relationship that exists between them. So, industrial relations is the study of such employment relationships or work relationships. So, if we say, that means there are, when we talk of industrial relations, it primarily consists of labor management relations. Labor means workers or employees who have been employed, and management means the employers or the group of the employer or the group of employers. Now, it is equally important to manage such relationships because relationships are very fragile. If we fail to handle them properly, or if we fail to manage them properly, it would have a deep impact on the industry. So that is why we are focusing on the management of industrial relations. So that was the introduction to the subject Management of Industrial Relations. Now we will understand unit by unit. We will understand with the basic unit, that is unit 1. Now, unit 1 again, it says concept of industrial relations. Just now we have understood that industrial relations refers to the relationship that exists within industries or within organizations, and such relationships are also called employment relations or employment relationships. So we will understand it in much detail because it contains, as said, the study of labor management relationship and also the study of employee-employee relationship, that is relationship between workmen and workmen. So there are, we will understand it in detail. Now, scope of IR. Scope means again the complex verb relationship that is part of IR, we will study it. That is labor management relationships, workmen-workmen relationships, relationships between trade union and employers, etc., etc., and also relationship between industry and society at large. Now, we will also understand the importance of IR. Why is it important to study such relationships? As said, such relationships play an important role in enhancing any organization's productivity and efficiency. Just imagine a place, where people are not cooperating with one another. They are having all kinds of issues or disputes. In such an environment, obviously, an industry cannot progress. It cannot make progress. So if you want that the organization should make progress, it should reap more benefits, we should focus on the complex web of relationships, that is IR. So it is very important to secure industrial progress and also to secure industrial peace and industrial democracy. Now, parties to IR, we will understand the various parties to IR. Now, parties means the actors in an IR system, the players in an IR system. There are various players in an IR system, like workers and their associations, management and their associations, and the government. Now we will take up these. First is workers, also called employees. Now workers have their associations, which are called trade unions. Such associations, that is trade unions, are there to protect the basic rights of the workers. So they have an important role to play. So we will understand how the trade unions are securing the benefit of the workers. We will also understand the role of management or the employer and their associations. And we will also understand the role of the government. As you know, the government is also one of the parties to IR. It also has its role to play. Now, what role does the government play? It acts as a watchdog. It is a regulating body, you know, it regulates the industrial relations. So the government has its role to play. It is there to protect the rights or interests of the workers as well as the employers. And from time to time, the government enacts various laws which are known as labor laws and also industrial laws. So these, the government has enacted various laws from time to time to preserve the rights of the workers. So the government also gives some guidelines from time to time. It also frames some agreements in this regard. So these are the parties to IR. Now another topic that unit 1 contains is collective bargaining. Now what is collective bargaining? Just understand, we have understood that industrial relations is the study of employment relations, primarily the relationship between management and employees. But it also includes the machinery or the processes through which such relationships can be expressed. And one such machinery is collective bargaining. So we could say that collective bargaining is a machinery or a mechanism that exists in the industry to express the working relationships or industrial relationships. So we will understand what is collective bargaining, its meaning, its types also, its process, it is a process in itself, and how it is going to be helpful for both the parties to industrial relations. Other than collective bargaining, there are other machineries also. We will also understand those machineries, like code of discipline, code of conduct, grievance handling machinery, etc., etc. So these all are the machineries that exist through which the relationships can be expressed. So that was unit 1. Now we move to unit 2. Now unit 2 contains topics like workers' participation in management. Now what is this workers' participation in management? As we said, you know, the employees, they are one of the key actors or key parties to industrial relations. Now obviously the worker or the employee, he is giving his input to the industry, to the organization. Now he wants to be heard. You know, the employee wants that his voice should be heard by the management. As such, workers' participation in management is a machinery that exists within industries so that the workers can be heard, their voices can be, you know, reached at higher levels to the management levels. So this is the concept of workers' participation in management. It ensures that the workers' opinion and their ideas, their suggestions are valued. So that is there. Through such machinery, the workers can express their opinions to higher authorities. Now there are various modes of participation, like works committee, like joint management councils, shop councils, plant councils, etc., etc. So these are the machineries that exist for expressing their views. In the same manner, there are quality circles also. And another machinery that exists is grievance handling machinery, which is also a machinery to express their grievances, that is the grievances of the workers. Now unit 3 contains some acts. As said, the government has enacted various acts from time to time. We will understand a brief introduction of these acts, like the Trade Union Act 1926, the Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act 1946, the Industrial Disputes Act 1947. Now there are some more acts that is part of Unit 4, like the Payment of Wages Act 1936, the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, the Minimum Wages Act 1948, the Payment of Bonus Act 1965. Similarly, some more acts in Unit 5, that is the Factories Act 1948, the Provident Fund and Miscellaneous Provisions Act 1952, the Employees Pension Scheme and Employees State Insurance Act 1948. So that were some acts that are there in your curriculum. So that was your entire syllabus. Thank you.